Emily Sunday.
Hello.
So your album is called Our Version of Events.
Yes.
It's going to be released in France in March on the 12th. So what's your version of events that happened the last few months? I mean, it's a great success in UK. You're number one in the UK chart. So yes. First, congratulations.
Thank you. Tell
us about it.
The past year has been very, very fast. Mm-hmm. I released my first single in the UK, Heaven, mm-hmm. In the summer. And then it all just kind of was very quick, and then yesterday I found out that my album is number one, and my second single next to me is number two, so very exciting.
Oh, congratulations again, that's absolutely crazy.
Yes.
You used to be a student last mm-hmm. year.
Year? 3 years ago I was studying medicine, I was going to be a doctor, mm-hmm. and then I decided I want to take a year out of medicine. I became a songwriter in London. Mm-hmm. So I wrote for a lot of people like Leona Lewis, Susan Boyle, Tani Tempah, like mm-hmm. rappers in the UK. And then I got signed as an artist, mm-hmm. and then the whole of last year was crazy. Find him, I'll find him next to me.
When the skies are gray and all the doors are closing. So you're a songwriter, and do you write songs for yourself as you write songs for the other singers that you mentioned before? Is that the same process?
It depends. Usually I just write a song with nobody in mind, mm-hmm. and then once it's finished I say, is this very personal to me? Is this my own story? Then mm-hmm. I'll keep it for myself. But and then sometimes I'll say, oh, this sounds like a song for Leona Lewis, or this sounds like a song for so-and-so. So I usually once the song is finished, then I decide who's it for.
Okay, so how have you decided to start singing your own compositions?
Well, I always thought in my head I want to release my own album, mm-hmm. I want to be my own artist, but I guess when I wrote Heaven, that was the first time I thought, this is my first single, this is how I want to introduce myself. So when I wrote Heaven, I felt very ready to kind of let's go. Mm-hmm. Will you recognize me?
What is Heaven about? Because apparently it's something you wrote with your producer.
Yes.
Is that it? Can you tell us a bit more about the first single?
Yeah, well, Heaven I wrote with a producer called Naughty Boy. Mm-hmm. And Heaven, I guess, for me is like a confession to heaven or to God saying, I'm trying to be good, but sometimes there's just so much going on. Like by the end of the day, you've messed up again. So mm-hmm. it's kind of about waking up every morning with good intentions mm-hmm. and hoping that this time you'll get it right.
But your songs are a lot about love and failures, and I'd say maybe the dark side of life. Why do you choose to talk about that?
I try and keep my songs with a positive message and hopefully leave the listener with a sense of hope of something. Mm-hmm. But I love to speak about everyday life. You know, I love to kind of, I hope my music can reflect things that are going on mm-hmm. in everyday life. So I try and just speak about the ordinary things.
Ordinary things.
Yes.
So, okay, sad things sometimes.
Sometimes sad, mm-hmm. sometimes confusing. But, you know, just this relationship's the realistic side of everything.
So we just said you were a medical student. Mm-hmm. You quit. Was that the crazy thing to do or a reasonable thing?
I'm sure so. At the time, I'm sure a lot of my professors and lecturers thought it was a crazy thing to do. But for me, I thought it was reasonable because you know, music was something I've been passionate about for so long. Mm-hmm. And when I got published as a writer, I felt like, okay, I have a company behind me now. And I'd already graduated with neuroscience, so mm-hmm. I had a degree. So I felt in my head, I thought, this is the time to do it. And I really felt I had a good shot in the music industry. Mm-hmm.
Because you compose songs since you were born.
Yeah.
I mean, with your parents, they encouraged you a lot to compose and sing.
Yes.
Is that it?
Well, my dad is very musical. He introduced me to a lot of great artists, but I just wanted to, you know, they don't write music. I just, mm-hmm. when I was very young, I wanted to write songs. I wanted to create something from nothing. And I nagged them all the time to play piano and get lessons. Mm-hmm. And it was very my biggest passion when I was young.
Okay, so I know you have a tattoo from Frida Kahlo.
Yes.
Is she kind of a muse for you? Who are those who inspire you?
Frida Kahlo, definitely. I mean, she reminds me to be a very strong woman when mm-hmm. I see her, and she was very brave with her art. And she also was going to study medicine, and she likes the dark side of things, and mm-hmm. she's very honest with her art. So her, I love Nina Simone. I think she's fantastic. Mm-hmm. Jacqueline Dupre was a cellist from England who I'm a big fan of. Lots of people. Nina Simone, okay. Alicia Keys, people, strong women who really kind of stick by what they want.
Okay, so a lot of critics said that you write songs like in the 90s. I mean, Heaven sounds a bit like Massive Attack. Mm-hmm. I read that. So have you listened to this music a lot in the 90s? Are they part of your influences or not very much?
I was too young with the first when they came out, like 93. I was only 6. Mm-hmm. So I wasn't listening to... But when I was about 16 or 17, mm-hmm. I worked in Virgin Megastores. Mm-hmm. And so I'd flick back and I'd really... rediscovered these people. So yeah, definitely Massive Attack, I'm a big fan. I love Portishead as well. The whole Bristol scene is very inspiring, and you know, it definitely reminded me of living in Glasgow and that kind of industrial city. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I'm a big fan, and definitely inspire me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You'll have a gig at the in France on the mm-hmm. 26th of March.
Yes.
At the Alhambra. So what would you say to French people that don't know you yet to make them come?
I would say we're going to be rehearsing a lot, so it'll mm-hmm. be a good show. It'll be a very soulful show, and yeah, I hope I can introduce myself and my music to people here in France, and I'm really excited about it, so I hope they come along.
We can't wait to listen to your album. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Merci beaucoup d'avoir été avec nous, et à très bientôt. Bye.
Bye.
Will you recognize me in the flashing lights? I try to keep my heart.